Hello. In this video, I will be showing you how to use the Model Target option in Vuforia to make an augmented reality app. In our previous videos, we discussed how to configure Unity with Vuforia. If you have not watched them, you can click on the link in the description box to watch them. We use Model Target to scan an object in the real world and see an augmented reality object on top of or near it using a mobile app. We can use this feature to create an augmented reality app that can show the guidelines or the names of the parts of a particular machine in a factory when the camera is aimed at it. I will now show you how that can be done. First, go to the developer.vuforia.com website and go to the Tools tab of the Downloads tab. You will see this software called Vuforia Model Target Generator. You can download and install this software application for Windows and Apple. I have already done so. These are some of the databases that I have generated. To create these databases, we need a 3D model of the specific object seen in the real world. In this instance, I will be using this model of a controller of a VR headset. I will start by clicking the Create New Model Target button and selecting the file of the 3D model. I am going to select the 3D model of the controller that I chose and click Open. I'm going to change the name of the model target to Controller HTC Vive and click Create Model Target. You will then be able to see the 3D model that we input like this. You have to select the correct up vector from the options that they provide us with here. I have chosen this one along the y-axis and then confirmed it. You have to then select the dimensions of the particular object in the real world. You should be as accurate as possible when choosing these values. I will change the units from meters to decimeters here. You can select the most suitable one according to the dimensions of the object that you have chosen. I'm going to click Select. I'm going to choose the default tracking option here and click Confirm. I can choose to create a guide view here. Between these options, we should select the Create Guide View option and click Next Step. We will then be able to select the most suitable field of view of the objects when we see them on our phone. Afterwards, you can click on the Create Guide View button. We are now able to see a rectangle around the object, which will be the view through our phones. The guide view is created to allow it to easily recognize the object when it is in a particular orientation. You can create a simple guide view like this, or create a more advanced one. I will delete the guide view that we created. I will click Create Advanced View and click Next Step. We are then provided with several options. As this controller is similar to a tool and we will want to view the AR objects that we place from all angles, I will select the full 360 degrees option. You can select the one that is most suited to the purpose of scanning your object by reading these descriptions that they have provided. When I click Next Step again, we will be able to see this view. I will then click on the Create Full 360 Degree View option and click the Generate Advanced Model Target button. In the Advanced Model Target, we are able to create a database like this by clicking the Create Database button. After clicking it, we have to add the model. This is the last model that we added. I will then click the Add Model Target button. We can then see that the model target that we created needs to be trained. This is because we want to view the model target that we added in 360 degrees. I will click Continue here. You can see that it is being trained now. It takes a few hours for this training to be completed. I have a database that I trained earlier with me. I used the same HTC controller previously as well and trained it. It took about 4 hours to be trained, so I will export the one that has already been trained. After clicking the export button, I will be able to do so. You can see that there is also a Unity package which has been created in the exported folder. Let's go back to Unity and right-click on the scene. We can then go to the Vuforia options and create a model target game object. I have already done so here. You can see the databases here say empty. I will then double-click on the exported package and import it like this. You can click on this drop-down list next to database and select the database that we just imported from here, which is controller HTC123. You can then see that controller HTC has been selected as the model target. You can now see a preview of our model target here. You have to then select Model Target and tick the Model Target Behavior script box. You can see the dimensions for physical length, physical width, and physical height here. These can be changed again from here. You have to provide the dimensions of the actual object here. I am going to leave these dimensions as they are for now. Now I am going to place the 3D objects that we need to see when the actual object is scanned in the real world. You must make sure to add them as child objects under the model target game object. I have already placed a few child objects here. You can see that I have used some simple texts and created some child objects here. I have added the names of the buttons of the controller on it. We can also use another model of the same 3D models and create an effect to make it seem like it is being scanned. I will show you what I mean. I have used another copy of the model that we had and added this force field effect asset onto it. These types of assets can be downloaded for free from the Unity Asset Store. I have placed it on top of it like this. I have added it in order to visually show that I am scanning it when I point my camera at it. The objects that are on the back of the controller should not be seen when we scan it. When we scan the object and see its front view, the 3D objects at the back should not be seen. We can add an occlusion shader for that. I have created this 3D object by adding an occlusion shader. When this is placed properly, the 3D objects at the back cannot be seen. After you have set up your scene like this, you can save it and build it. You can build it by going to File, going to Build Settings, and then selecting the scene that you have created. You will have to change a few of the settings in Player Settings. You should go to Other Settings and change the minimum API level to Android 8.0 or a version that has been released more recently, like Android Oreo. You should then change the target API level to the highest installed option. The scripting backend should be changed to IL2 CPP and the target architecture should be ARM64. We can then build an APK by clicking Build here, giving it a suitable name and clicking Save. It will then start being built. This is the way that we will be able to see it once the APK has been installed to a phone. Once our camera is pointed at an HTC Vive controller, we will be able to view the game objects as seen here. I hope that you have learned something from this video. I'll see you next time.
Thank you so much for watching the video. We're so glad that you joined us on the Render Island channel today. We're always creating new content for Unity developers, so please subscribe to our channel and click the notification bell. I'm looking forward to seeing you in the next one.